السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In this video, we discuss the first part of the last chapter in our curriculum, and this chapter is titled Provoked Nuclear Reaction. The objectives of this chapter are: determine the mass defect of a nuclear reaction and the liberated energy, then identify the characteristics of fission in nuclear reaction. Also, we will discuss the chain nuclear reaction. And the last objective is to identify the characteristics of fusion nuclear reaction. But in this video, we explain the first objective. It is noticed that the mass of the parent nucleus that undergoes radioactivity is larger than the mass of the product. So we can say that the mass is not conserved and there is a loss in mass. This loss in mass is known as mass defect, and it is denoted by delta M. It is equal to the difference in mass between the reactant mass and the product mass. The SI unit of the mass is kilogram, but since the mass of a nucleus is very small, then the mass of the nucleus is given an atomic mass unit U, and there is a relation between U and kilogram. 1 U is equal to 1.66 times 10 power minus 27 kilogram. According to Einstein mass energy equivalence, the loss in masses is converted into energy, and this energy is called liberated or released energy. It is equal to mass defect times the square of the speed of light in vacuum. The SI unit of energy is joule, and C is equal to 3 times 10 power 8 meter per second. Note that if the mass defect is positive, then the energy is liberated or released. And if the mass defect is negative, then the energy is consumed. Let's practice on how to determine the mass defect and the liberated energy. We have in this application a uranium 238 that is decayed into thorium and helium. Given that the mass of each element, and we have also C and how to convert from U to kilogram. We have to determine the liberated energy in this question. We know that the liberated energy is related to the mass defect. So in order to find it, we should first calculate the mass defect. The mass defect is defined as the difference in masses between the reactant and the product of the nuclear reaction. So we should subtract the mass of uranium and the mass of both thorium and helium. We get 0.004578 U. But the SI unit of delta M is kilogram. So we have to convert this mass into kilogram by multiplying it by 1.66 times 10 power minus 27. So delta M become 7.59948 times 10 power minus 30 kilogram. Now we can apply the formula of the liberated energy. E is equal to delta M times the square of the speed of light in vacuum or in air. We substitute the values and we get 6.839 times 10 power minus 13 joule. In application 2, we have a nickel element born in the excited state, and then it de-excited into nickel with emission of gamma radiation. In the given, we have the mass of the daughter nucleus, and we have the liberated energy from this decay. Also, the conversion in units from U to kilogram, or from mega electron volt, MeV, to joule, are provided. In the first question, we have to calculate the mass defect. We don't have the mass of the parent nickel, so we cannot determine the mass defect by making the difference in masses between reactant and the product. But we can use the relation of the liberated energy because we have it. So the mass defect is equal to the liberated energy divided by the square of the speed of light in vacuum. We have to convert the energy from mega electron volt to joule. Then we get delta M equal to 2.3689 times 10 power minus 30 kilogram. But it was recommended to find delta M in U, so we have to divide this number by 1.66 times 10 power minus 27, and then we get delta M equal to 1.427 times 10 power minus 3 U. In the second question, we have to calculate the mass of the parent nickel in U. Right now, we can apply delta M equal mass reactant minus mass product. In the reactant, we have nickel born in the excited state minus nickel in the ground state. Then the mass of the parent nickel is equal to delta M plus mass of nickel in the ground state. I substitute the values and then we get 59.932 U. In the summary of this part, we have seen that the mass defect is defined as the difference in masses between the reactant and the product of a given nuclear reaction. If the mass defect is positive, then this mass appears in the form of liberated energy, and this energy can be calculated using the relation E equal delta M times the square of the speed of light in vacuum. And at the end, I recommend from you to watch this video many times and ask your teacher any question for more details. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.